important session was organized by the college in collaboration with the District Employment and Counseling Center, Kulgam, on 21st July 2022 in the college conference hall regarding the self-employment schemes available for the young and budding entrepreneurs in the valley. The session was planned and designed to encourage and motivate students to generate employment opportunities in rural as well as urban areas of the valley through setting up of new self-employment ventures, projects and micro enterprises. The session was devised jointly by the Career Counseling Guidance and Placement Cell, Department of Commerce, Entrepreneurship and Innovation Cell of the College and District Employment and Counseling Center, Kulgam. Professor Dr. Manzoor Ahmed Loon, were the principal, inaugurated the session with the formal welcome address and stipulated on the problem of unemployment prevalent in the UT of J&K, need and importance of self-employment, and stressed the students to venture into it and focus on starting their own small units. Ms. Shazila Qureshi, District Employment Officer, discussed and deliberated on the National Career Service Initiative of the government, its objectives, implementation uses, and promoted the student for the on-spot registration in the session. Rozia Jan, Employment Officer, discussed that to overcome the problem of unemployment and find new employment opportunities, Government of India has implemented several schemes to help overcome the problem and find new employment opportunities. She detailed the students about the self-employment schemes of the government, while she pointed out the eligibility criteria, nature of scheme, funding requirements, and amount of subsidies and interest. She highlighted the schemes like Entrepreneurship Initiative, Tejaswini, the Radiant Scheme, Rise Together Scheme, Tourist Village Development Scheme, etc. The session was attended by the Head Department of Commerce, Professor Sabah Iqbal, and Head Department of Business Administration, Dr. Ijazul Islam. Members of Counseling, Guidance and Placement Cell, Entrepreneurship and Innovation Cell, and students of BCom and BBA, and other non-teaching faculty from the college. The event was moderated by Professor Parvez Ahmed Mir, Coordinator of Career Counseling, Placement and Guidance Cell. The session was followed by an important question-answer session in which the students raised some important questions related to the self-employment schemes and National Career Service Portal, and were jointly answered by Ms. Shazila Qureshi and Rozia Jan, Employment Officers. The event concluded with a vote of thanks by Professor Shahid Yusuf Gilkar, National Service Scheme NSS Unit of the college, organized South Kashmir Inter-College Quiz competition on the theme Freedom Movement of India on 27th July 2022. 10 degree colleges, including the host college of South Kashmir, participated in the said competition. Each college was presented by two students. The program started at 11:30 a.m. in the college conference hall and was moderated by Dr. Safir Ahmed Bhatt, NSS Program Officer. Dr. Shabir Ahmed Padar, Vice Principal of the host college, formally welcomed the guests and inaugurated the proceedings of the national competition. In his introductory remark, he shed light on the rich legacy of Indian national movement and stressed on the need to imbibe its values among the younger generation. Mr. Arshid Ahmed Thokar, faculty at GDC Kulgam, Dr. Mudassir Ahmed, faculty at GDC Pulwama, and Dr. Tawseef Ahmed Mir, faculty at GDC Tral, performed their duty as jury. The teams had been arranged alphabetically and questions were posed to them in their suggers. The quiz comprised of 7 rounds. The last round was a rapid-fire round in which questions were asked to all the teams, and the one which pressed the buzzer first was given the opportunity to answer it. Government Degree College Kulgam secured the first position, while Government Degree College Kellam and Duru secured second and third positions respectively. The position holders were felicitated and were given trophies and merit certificates in the award ceremony, chaired by Dr. Shabir Ahmed Padar. Besides, all the participants were given certificates of participation. The program concluded with a vote of thanks by Dr. Mudassir Ahmed, assistant professor from Government Degree College for Women, Pulwama. On 5th July 2022, Department of Biochemistry organized one-day study tour for 5th, 4th and 3rd semester students. The purpose of visit was to enhance student interests, knowledge and motivation. It was also aimed at fostering a spirit of scientific inquiry and creativity among students. Students went to Duisburg, which is a meadow wild habitat and hence a non-agriculture habitat. The research methodology was divided into 3 parts: interviewing the students, observing the nature, and taking photographs. Students collect some medicinal plants to the lab to analyze their chemical nature and for isolating their active ingredients to assess their biology effects, like antioxidant and antimicrobial activity. They found insects feeding on the rare wild host plants. They brought insects in the lab to feed on the plant and check its complete life cycle. The plant material can be further used for DNA analysis to identify the species of the plants that was said by the department's HOD, Dr. Muhammad Iqbal. The faculty, students, and support staff of the Department of Computer Applications went to attend software cum industrial tour at Nilet Rangreet Srinagar. The students, along with the escorting staff, went to the auditorium where NIELIT authorities had arranged a special event for GDC Kulgam and SSM College of Engineering Science. The title of the event was Future Skill Orientation and College to Employment Roadmap. The event started at 11 a.m. The participants and resource persons were welcomed by Ashik Hussain Dar, Science Study, NIELIT. Keynote address was delivered virtually by Shri Deepak Vasan, Executive Director, Nilet J&K. Mr. Yunus Asad, Director, Elite Senior, in his lecture, enlightened the students about various employment opportunities and approaches for planning a good employment after completing their degrees. Syed Nisar Bukhari, Scientist C. Nilet, delivered a technical session on artificial intelligence and machine learning. The students then visited the data science lab and other computer labs of NIELIT. Other than having summer vacation in July 2022, the college worked really hard in each field, both curricular as well as co-curricular exercises. The headliners that were finished during this month were admission of PG first semester batch 2022 under NEP through online mode, facilitation for students to avail different type of scholarships, installation of water purifiers for primary stockholders, and installation of biometric attendance system for the faculty. PMSSS verification, document verification centers for students of Kulgam. Development and deployment of bona fide portal by Department of EC. Getting feedback from students online and consolidate the result thereof. In addition to these two meetings between staff and worthy principal sir were also held. The important issues discussed there were like discipline, maximize overall development in infrastructure as well as digital initiatives, staff appreciation, and minimizing student-teacher gap. Along with these two meetings of IQEC were also held. These solved some important issues like the Alumni Association meet, the national level seminar, conduct of national level seminar, and student program. NSS unit of the college organized Digital India Week 2022 celebrations from 25th to 30th July 2022. The celebration was aimed at enhancing the digital awareness level and engaging the stakeholders about the digital initiatives taken by the government. A number of programs were conducted during the week, which saw the participation of NSS volunteers, students, and teaching and non-teaching staff of the college. The celebration of the Digital Week was inaugurated on 25th July at 11:30 a.m. by the principal of the college, Professor Dr. Manzoor Ahmed Loon, who deliberated on the importance of Digital India and its role in easing the lives of common people. He exhorted the volunteers to be digitally aware and play their in disseminating information about cyber jagrukta. The program was coordinated by Dr. Safir Ahmed, but NSS program officer. On 25th July, a workshop on the mentioned theme, that is Digital India for a Common Citizen, was conducted in the college conference hall. In the first session, Mr. Irshad Ahmed Loon, Assistant Professor Computer Applications, delivered a lecture on e-governance, empowering common man. He discussed in detail about the e-governance initiatives taken by the government and their role in mitigating the miseries of a common man. The speaker discussed about Aadhaar, MyGov, DigiLocker, CSC, and other digital initiatives taken by the government. It was held that the e-governance has not only significantly improved the governance, but has also reduced the scope of corruption. In the second session, Dr. Hashim Iqbal Malik delivered a talk on e-governance, minimum government, maximum governance. He deliberated on the transition of governance from physical to electronic mode and its changing contours, the efforts of the government in reaching to the common masses were discussed, and it was held that governance has become more effective and inclusive as a result of transition to e-governance. The speaker talked about the digital divide and held that the challenge before the government was to make the digital technology inclusive. The session was followed by a question-answer session in which volunteers raised some important questions on Digital India. The event concluded with a vote of thanks by Dr. Safir Ahmed Bhatt, NSS program officer. A seminar on the theme was organized on 26th July in the conference hall. Dr. Safir Ahmed Bhatt inaugurated the proceedings of the seminar and talked about the relevance of Digital India. The resource person of the day, Dr. Muhammad Yunus Bhatt, Senior Assistant Professor of Political Science, deliberated upon the different aspects of Digital India and its role in the transformation of education sector. Holding the digital technologies have revolutionized education and have made it more inclusive and accessible. The speaker held that the massive potential of the digital technology needs to be tapped, cautioning about the overuse of digital gadgets It was held that the users need to maintain a balance between the digital and personal lives or social lives. Talking about digital divide, the speaker put forward the statistics that a large number of people in India did not own digital gadgets, and therefore it should not become a barrier in imparting education. The lecture was followed by a question-answer session and concluded with a vote of thanks by Dr. Hashim Iqbal Malik. On 28th July, a technical session was organized on the mentioned theme. The resource person of the day, Dr. Ijazul Islam, Assistant Professor of Business Administration, deliberated on the different aspects of e-banking. He held that the transition to e-banking has massively transformed the banking sector and eased the lives of a common person. Deliberating on the potential of e-banking in making the banking system accessible, the speaker held that e-banking can make the financial system inclusive. It was held that e-banking had led to better efficiency, lower costs, lesser errors, and a transparent system. However, there were increasing risks of financial fraud, and proper care needed to be taken to ensure that the transactions are safe and secure. In the second session, Digital India films were screened, which showcased the different digital initiatives of government. The event concluded with a vote of thanks by Mr. Arshid Ahmed Thokar, Assistant Professor Education. On 29th July, an awareness program on Cyber Jagrukta was organized. The resource person, Mr. Sajjad Ahmed Shah, Senior Assistant Professor Computer Applications, explained in detail the important concepts related to cyber crimes, including cyber threats, stalking, phishing, hacking, money laundering, and cyber terrorism. Students were made aware about different crimes that are punishable under law and were taught as to how to behave as responsible citizens while using the resources available on the internet. He stressed on the need to spread cyber awareness and emphasized on the role of conscious civil society. Members in instilling the consciousness regarding the cyber threats. The Government Degree College Kulgam is one of the best higher educational institution of the district Kulgam. The college, other than the higher learning, offers many services to the local community in the form of NSS, NCC, sports, IGNU, study center, MANU, etc. Currently, the college is conducting the IGNU Termed examination, the MANU examination, and the fifth semester regular examination, in which more than 4,000 to 5,000 examinees are appearing. This is one of the biggest academic exercise going in the district Kulgam. The college, under the incumbent principal Dr. Manzoor Ahmed Doon, has taken some great measures to ensure the smooth and fair conduct of the examination. The principal has directed the coordinators for ensuring the presence of sufficient staff and other necessary arrangements. The principal himself visits the examination venue on daily basis and ensure the fair conduct of examination.